Hi guys, welcome back to my channel, and if you're new, welcome. In this tutorial, I'm gonna show you how to crochet raglan cardigans. So raglan cardigans have no shoulder seam. Once you'll start chaining to make the cardigans, you will need to chain another because everything will be included in the first chain. You'll just need to repeat the same process, and the back piece, front piece, neckline and the sleeve will form by itself. So without further ado, let's begin. For this project, you will need your selected yarn, scissor, 4mm crochet hook and yarn needle. Make a slip knot and chain a total of 90. After chaining 90, chain 1 again. Now let's begin row 1. Work 12 single crochet, 1 in each chain. After working 12 single crochet, chain 1. And into the next chain, work 20 single crochet. After working 20 single crochet, chain 1. And from the next chain, work 26 single crochet. After working 26 single crochet, chain 1 again. After that, again work 20 single crochet from the next chain. After working 20 single crochet, chain 1. Now, you'll have only 11 chains left, so work 1 single crochet in each. Row 1 is complete, so for the next row, chain 1 and turn your work. Work 11 single crochet that we have just crocheted. And into the chain space that we have made in row 1, work 1 single crochet, chain 2. And again, 1 single crochet into the same stitch. It's a 1 row repeat, so the process is same. You will need to work 1 single crochet in all the stitches. But you have to keep in mind that into the chain stitch that we made in previous row, you will need to work 1 single crochet, chain 2, and then 1 single crochet again into the same stitch. Repeat this till the end of the row. chain 1 and turn your work. So the process is same from the previous row, and make another 26 rows again. So for these cardigans, you will need to increase while making rows. It will increase by itself. Now, we will join the another slip by working one single crochet. After that, from the next stitch, work one single crochet in all the stitches. Chain 1, turn your work. Now, work one single crochet in all the stitches for the body piece. You don't need to crochet the sleeve right now. Start working from this round till the last stitch and crochet till your desired length. Now the body piece is done. For myself, I have crocheted 66 rows. I'll show you how to crochet the sleeves now. Make a slip knot. Insert your hook into the join stitch. Make a slip stitch and chain 1. And now, work one single crochet in all the stitches. And slip stitch to join the round. Chain 1 and turn your work. Repeat this again and again in all the rows until you reach your desired length. Once you are done, we'll make decrease in next 3 rows. chain 1 and turn your work. One single crochet into the next 3 stitches. And into the next stitch, make a decrease. One single crochet into the next 3 stitches. And into the next stitch, make a decrease. Repeat this and complete the round. After working 3 rounds of decrease, let's make hand ribbing directly. Chain 3. Work 1 double crochet in all the stitches. Chain 1 and turn your work. Now we're going to make back post and front post double crochet for the ribbing. yarn over and insert your hook around the back of your double crochet and work a double crochet. This is called front post double crochet. Next, back post double crochet. Insert your hook through the back of the work around the stitch, yarn over and make a normal double crochet. And you have to repeat front post and back post again and again to complete the round. Chain 1, turn your work. So in this round, you have to do exactly like the previous round. So in the previous round, if you have made front post, then you have to work front post here. And if back post, then back post, double crochet. Repeat this and complete the round. If you want your ribbing to be long, then continue making rows. The process will be the same. And if you're done ribbing, slip stitch, chain 1, and cut the yarn. Now we have to rib the front part. From here we will start working double crochet till the next part. So make a slip knot. Insert your hook, make a slip stitch and chain 2. start working one double crochet in all the stitches. Chain 1, turn your work. Now we're going to make back post and front post double crochet for the ribbing. And here is the final look. So if you like this video, give it a thumbs up, subscribe, and don't forget to hit the bell icon. Thank you for watching.